Is Joe Biden already the worst president in US history? There was a tragic inevitability about yesterday's terror attacks. In fact, we were warned about it. 13 US servicemen died, around 90 civilians, and it's believed that around 150 others were wounded. First, it's the first US troop deaths since February 2020. Now, Joe Biden is trying to blame Trump, saying he negotiated with terrorists and set a deadline that tied his hands. Whilst that may be true, it wasn't Donald Trump who turned the Taliban from a ragtag bunch of AK-47-wielding militiamen into an incredibly well-equipped fighting machine. Joe Biden's incompetence means that the Taliban has been left with $85 billion worth of American military equipment, 75,000 vehicles, 200 aeroplanes and helicopters. The Taliban now has more Black Hawk helicopters than 85% of the world's countries, apparently. They're a few pilots away, frankly, from having a formidable air force, aren't they? They have night vision goggles, body armour, medical supplies and even biometric devices with fingerprints and eye scans of Afghans who helped the US troops in the last 20 years. So Biden armed them and then handed their targets to them on a silver platter. To be fair, we've done something similar. The betrayal of our Afghan interpreters was already palpable, but it was given another shameful nail in the coffin as it emerged that we left documents scattered around our embassy with the names and contact details of interpreters and indeed the CVs of people who applied for interpreter jobs. Joe Biden vowed to hunt down and find ISIS-K terrorists and make them pay for the attack yesterday. So there is now a very real possibility that US troops will be sent on assassination missions to Afghanistan, where they will come under fire from their own weapons, which were handed to them. Donald Trump didn't do that. Joe Biden did. Donald Trump wanted to make America great again. Joe Biden has made the Taliban great again. The rescue mission will end today. We're being told that no more people than those already on the fly list will be able to leave Afghanistan. As that final plane takes off, leaving behind millions of innocent civilians, a Taliban more powerful than ever before, and streets painted with the blood of US and UK troops who died for nothing, let this be a lesson to us all. Trying to bring Western liberal democracy to countries like Afghanistan doesn't work. It's questionable whether or not the people even want it. It costs lives, it costs money, it costs us our reputation, our dignity, our standing on the world stage. That is not a price worth paying. Never again.